careful उस हिसाब से।
इन द चैट विंडो। Cool, thank you. Yeah, so we are giving you my background. Even I'm an engineer from SP, and I've done my engineering from 2015 batch of EHTC, and post which I started working as a business analyst in Zycus Infotech, which is a procurement product company. During which again, I started my CFA journey, and I completed CFA level one while I was at Zycus. Post my CFA level one, I actually felt the need to switch back to the core financial field, and that is how investment banking happened. To give you a background of about my firm, it is a boutique investment bank called as Duesberg Boston Financial Services. It's based out of Bombay. And it's an investment bank which deals with a couple of sectors like agriculture, renewable, and also some part of lending, right? And meanwhile, while I was in that firm, I completed my level two and level three as well. And currently, my charter is awaiting, right? So that's about me, about 4 years of work experience, of which close to 3 years is in finance. And have completed my CFA level three. So that's about me right now. Let's just starting this webinar by understanding that you are a clean slate right now and would like to know more about what are the career opportunities in finance, how do people perceive an engineering student in financial world, and we'll cover up some parts of CFA as well. Feel free to stop me in chat window if you don't understand anything, or if there's any specific question you need me to answer to understand if we are going on the correct track, right? So let me give you some overview about what engineer, specifically being an engineer, what can one do post engineering, right? So I am sure since you are an SP and last year student, you must have heard about this profile, JP Morgan CRG, right? Just type yes or no in the chat window if you have heard about it. Correct. Yeah. So that is probably only profile which comes to Sardar Patel, and suddenly because it pays you well and there's a good career growth path out there, it becomes dream profile of most of the students. But here you have to understand that financial world and technology world, these are two very, very, very big domains out there. And JP Morgan CRG is just one drop in the entire ocean we can probably see out there once you actually go out, right? So I can empathize with you if you don't know many jobs out in finance, but only CRG, because that was the case for me as well when I was in my last year, right? So yeah, I'll just take the baton from our JP Morgan CRG point itself, and we'll take it forward. So career in finance, be it engineer, be it an MBA, be it just a BCom, be it majors in finance, be it masters in finance. Career in finance can be broadly divided into typical domains. One would be investment banking. If you want to write it down, just write it down. Investment banking. One is private equity and venture capitalist. One is treasury. One is corporate banking. So these are broadly four divisions, and currently upcoming fintech, which is again collaborating your financial world and technological world, right? So these are basically five domains which I can think of broadly, which are available for you as an analyst, to get into as an at an analyst level, right? Engineering, if you ask me, which is the most easiest one to get into, then that is fintech or investment banking. So let me give you a background about investment banking itself first. So for the next 5-7 minutes, I will speak about investment banking, and if you think you need more explanation about something, just type it out, right? So what exactly is investment banking and how can engineers fit into it? So just let me tell you that engineers 100% fit into the entire investment banking structure. And because being an investment banking analyst myself, I can assure you that there is no rocket science there. It's not an easy job, but again, it's not a job which you do for NASA, right? So again, it's something which can be easily adaptable, which is probably one of the most easiest getaway in finance. Like that is one job which you can easily do in finance. So just to throw a few names out there and divide it into those kind of firms. So these JP Morgan CRG profiles, Citibank investment banking analyst profile, Deutsche Bank investment banking profile, these three companies who are outsourcing their work to India. So basically the deal is going on in USA and those people are continuously monitoring the progress of the deal, and as and when they require some help at the support level, they send it back to India. So what your work will be as an analyst, you will probably work on US deals, but only as a support level. It won't give you a full background of investment banking. So after engineering, joining CRG is very good. Making CRG a career, you won't learn as much, right? So JP Morgan CRG is one of those jobs which are really hyped, and there are numerous such jobs within the industry. It is just that they don't come to SP. So if you are writing it down, I'm just throwing you three names here which hire engineers quite easily and quite frequently. One is JP Morgan CRG, one is Citibank, which is based out of Nirlon Park in Goregaon, and Deutsche Bank, which is again based out of Nirlon Park in Goregaon. These three firms, you can be rest assured if you have good amount of CGPA, because these guys are hell bent on CGPA, right? You need great CGPA. If you have good CGPA, then these three people are going to call you for an interview. So, but their work is always outsourced out of USA or whatever region they serve to. So you will be a support system of that field. But again, at a starting level, it is a good job to do for a couple of years and then move to the front end side of the domain. Right? After that, there are certain boutiques in India. Do you understand the boutique culture, Shah? When I say boutique culture, do you understand it? Just type yes or no in chat window. Cool. So, just to give you a background of boutique culture, okay, good. You don't understand me. Fine. So, again, I'm just throwing a few names. Arput Capital, Ambit Capital, Equirus Capital, my own firm. Like these firms are called as boutiques because their entire firm is of 10 to 15 to max 30 people, right? The max you go to is 30 people. And that is another investment banking opportunity you might come across. Now, they majoritarily hire engineers. You will be shocked to even empathize or even understand why do they do that. But they majoritarily out of their entire team, 70 to 80% of the analysts are engineers. Why so? Because engineers' math is really good, and in investment banking we require people having great aptitude for math. So when I'm hiring someone for investment banking, and if they tell me they have done commerce and they had no math for last 3 years, then I straight away don't even interview them. I just reject their profile, right? So these boutique firms, I might just type out a few names. These are not even, like, it's not a, what do you say? It's not a list which is even like 1% of the entire world I'm talking about when I talk about boutique. So how do they function here? There are lots of deals going on, but those deals are basically not happening at a macro India level. Like not every time you hear Walmart taking over Flipkart, right? So there are many, many, many deals happening over, and that is how these boutique firms come into play. So these firms basically hire engineers. You have to apply to them through a reference. You have to apply to them through you have to apply to through them through references or on their website. But it is very, very, very easy to get into those firms for an engineer from SP, because I have seen so many people converting their engineering jobs into those kind of jobs. Now, to give you a background of where can you apply the putting your profile to Michael Page. Michael Page is an HR company. I'm just typing it out. Michael Page is an HR firm which actually does a bulk of the hiring of these people. And again, these three names are not even 1% of the universe I'm talking about, right? You if you can just type it out, investment banking firms in India who serve Indian market, you will come across more than at least 100 firms which actually serve Indian market. But they are not JPs or Citis or Deutsche Bank of the world. They are very boutique in nature. Now, when I say boutique, what do you understand by boutique is, let's say there's a person who has worked in Kotak Investment Banking for about 15 years. He is fed up of his day job. He has a boss. He still is going out with the hierarchy, reporting to other people. He just gets fed up. He knows enough people in the industry. He starts up his own firm. He has this contact in the industry and leverages them quite easily. And that is how these teams are formed. And that is how these teams are very small, 12 to 15. Like my own firm, we are only 7 of us right now. And we are doing transactions of over 10 million per year, right? So just when I say boutique, don't be held aback, because in our college especially, there is a culture of following big brands. And investment banking generally in India don't work on brands. So just to give you a background, JP Morgan in India has less than 1% of the entire business, not even 1% of the business, right? So giving you a background that if you want to look at career opportunities in India of Indian firms, then these international banks shouldn't be your first point of contact. Okay, these should be your second or third point of contact. The Indian firms will not want to sell their try company. Then comes our normal big banks like ICICI, Kotak, Citibank, India. All those firms also have their investment banking arm. If you type right now, if you type on Google, Kotak Investment Banking, you will get to know how much Kotak is doing investment banking in India. Or you can type SBI Capital Markets. They are one of the better investment banks in India who pays you a lot, by the way. So with respect to investment banking, there are many opportunities apart from JP Morgan. And in why I'm emphasizing on JP repeatedly is because our college just lets you know about one company and 4 or 5 people, and that is also an optimistic case, get into JP Morgan, and the rest of them just leave the hope of joining finance unless and until they do an MBA, right? So if you want to know exactly what kind of investment banks are there in industry, go to any company's, any college's placement report and open their placement report. In that placement report, go to finance hiring, and then you'll understand what kind of finance jobs are available. And they are not only available for MBA freshers, but also engineering freshers as well, right? So I'm sure you got quite a bit insight about investment banking here. So can I move ahead with other, or you want to know more about investment banking or have any questions about investment banking? Because I've talked about firms more since it's about career opportunities after finance, or you would want to know what exactly happened in investment banking. Just type it out and I can answer that question. Because I don't want to take questions in the end. If you have any question about investment banking, so just letting you know, and again, the information which I have typed out is not even 1% of the universe. So what you can probably do is go to any B school's report and just see their finance placements, and then find out which all investment banks are there, right? That is what I did, and that is how I landed up a job without an MBA. And CSA didn't help. I'll be very frank to you. I didn't get this job because of CFA. I got it because of my own research. Cool. So the second domain is equity research. And I'll just skip VC. So VC and PE right now. Equity research is an arm of all financial services who gives you a background about how that particular stock is, right? So every firm I have mentioned right now, they have their own equity research arm. Now, as an engineer, it's very difficult for you to get into equity research because you need certain licenses to become an equity research analyst. And as an engineer, we cannot acquire those licenses because we are not formally trained in that domain. So I will ask you to just refrain from even searching for such job. That is a very interesting job, but with respect to SEBI requirements, an engineer cannot be an equity research analyst. So that we need a degree from commerce or an MBA at least. So even though it's a great field to explore after your MBA or and CFA doesn't qualify as financial degree, okay, in India. So equity research, I will strictly tell you to stay away from equity research domain in India, because you, even if you get a job there, you won't be having any name, any research under your name. So typically what happens is they write an entire research, let's say any stock you know right now, Infosys is a listed entity. Research firm would be to understand, yes, understand the business, understand if the stock price is 100 right now, whether it will move to 150 or it will move to 50. That will be your job. I'm leaving aside technical right now, that how you find it out, but your basic job is to make sure that Infosys is 50 from 100 level. Now, even though you can get a job, but they won't even consider you as an analyst because you don't have that license, which we get only after a professional formal education in finance, right? So I'll just refrain you from looking at the equity research. Not many people will tell you that, because I'm assuming if you are interested in finance, at some point of time, you'll be interested in doing your MBA as well. And it'll be a waste of time for you to look at equity research without a license, right? So if you can I move ahead with some other domain right now, you got about equity research, just say yes. Or no, whatever. Cool. So next is very interesting and my personal favorite, even though I am not working in that domain directly, but this is my personal favorite, which we keep hearing about but fail to understand at an early stage. So there are domains like VCs and PE. So what they typically do is, there are quite a few rich people in India. We must just acknowledge that. And those, let's say there are 5-7 rich people across the board, and they put in 5 lakhs each. That's 35 lakhs. 35 lakhs ka wo log ek fund banayenge, and they will keep you as their as the fund manager. And wo 35 lakhs you will invest in different private companies. So this entire structure is a VC structure. Venture capitalist is what they call the manager of the fund, right? So it is known as VC. So in that domain, there are different type of VCs as well. One VC, like for example, this company which we are actually having our chat on, What's Your Chase. What's Your Chase is a very new company, very exciting product which can be scaled to so many different heights. But right now it's not tested. So it's the early stage VC will invest into that phone. But at the same time, if we are investing in a company like Infosys, a very mature stage VC or PE, what they call them, PE will invest into that phone. So what are the kind of opportunities for engineers right now? If I were to give you a specific background about it, there are many opportunities because there are more than, let's say, 500 funds which I can tell you about it. Past two fund hai market mein right now. That all of these funds, like all, I'm talking about the best of best funds, follow boutique structure. Have you heard this name Sequoia? Just say yes or no. No, okay. So Sequoia Capital is basically India's biggest fund right now, and it has a team of 37 people only across 4 cities, right? So all these funds, VC or PE funds, they are 100% into boutique structure, and their salaries are so lucrative that once you join there, the iteration rate is very, very low. Now, how to get into those kind of firms? If you are a good student in engineering, by good I mean good CGPA, plus you have inclination towards finance and have an interest for new products in the market, like if you want to research about what is Vossior Chase doing, how Ayur has come up with this brilliant model of connecting people like you and me without even having much of a mutual connect right now. Like we are four years apart and I'm talking to you right now. You're basically getting information which I got through different channels with more than at least 6 months apart, but you're getting all this in, let's say, an hour or so, right? So if there's a product in the market which a VC would want to fund, so that would be your job. So how can you develop an acumen for that? First things first, they need a good CGPA. If your CGPA is less than 8.5, they won't even look at your profile. And I'm talking about all the funds here, because they need proof of concept ki bande ko mehnat karne aata hai. So if your CGPA is 7 right now and you are directly applying after engineering to those funds, make sure you have to get at least 1,000 rejections before getting one interview, right? So that is how they work, and that is how they have been working traditionally as well, and in future also will be with that. I can throw a few names at you right now, but it won't be of any use as such, because there are, like I said, it's thousand funds right now in the market. So I'll just tell you what to type on Google to understand what exactly you should be looking at. Just let me type it out. So they also follow sector-wise investment. So let's say there's a VC right now. Sequoia is one of the VC which I told you about. It's a very, very big firm, right? And they follow, they invest in companies which are technology-enabled or technology companies themselves. So they follow very strict, theme as such in investment. And there are so many funds in India, there are so many opportunities, and there are so many opportunities for engineers. Like their first go-to college is IIT Bombay. Every person who wants to do a career in finance is in some VC fund right now, right? So they hire engineers like anything right now. They just don't come to ST because our college has not created a big brand for itself right now for VC firms to come in, right? So but you can obviously apply offline. They always look at their opportunity, their hiring page very actively, and if not instantly, but you'll get their reply in about 5 to 7 days time, and it's very easy actually to reach out to some of them on LinkedIn. Just message their analyst on LinkedIn that I've applied, what do you think about my profile? And because it's a very, very, very niche team, like all their teams are about 5 to 7 people, they will talk about it. So rather than them rejecting us, it's we rejecting ourselves by not applying, right? So you can connect with, like I can help you with the name of some firm which might be of interest of SPIT, but I don't know how much lucrative it will be, but it won't be too difficult for you to apply there, right? And you have to basically understand what are your interests to apply to these firms. So if you are into consumerism right now, like Swiggy mein kaise kisne apply kiya, or Zomato mein kaise apply kiya, Zoom car mein kisne kyun apply invest kiya, so you should find out your domain of interest. There are very focused funds, and then you have to showcase them ki tumne kya kiya hai life mein. if I were to tell you about consumer market, you should have written some report for IEEE about developing consumer market in India, or what are fintech doing in India. Some courses on Coursera about finance. There are so many courses on Coursera about VC funding, VC investing. You can look at those courses to understand kaam kya hota hai wahan pe. Because even if they won't hire you just on the basis of your technical skills. These companies look at personalities more than technical skills. So because the finance itself is such a domain where technical skills are not that difficult to acquire, but your personality is what they look for. You can ask some of your friends from JP Morgan CRG and ask them how many technical questions were they asked. They were asked behavioral questions, and technical was okay. Like, these are the basic things. Like, one of my friend in JP Morgan got asked this question, ki bill mein kitne zero hote hai. That's like nothing, like main pass leta wo sab cheeze, right? So these are basically broad, three very, very bright opportunities in the industry. Do you have any queries about these VC or PE funds, Shyam? Cool. Any other queries as of today? As of now, because I'm sure from finance background and all this information is very new for you, like investment banking, equity research, VC or PE funds. This is very new information for you. I wanted to understand if you had any presumptions or any questions before even joining this session, so that I can address them. Are you there, Sam? Yeah, so I just asked if you had any presumptions or any questions even before the session started, because I've bombarded too much information on you right now. So if you had any questions even before that, the bombardment of information, I'd be happy to take those questions before we skip out any of them. Cool, seems like you had no presumptions as such before coming to this session. Okay, so since I've told you about three major sectors in finance and where can engineers find jobs, so that totally depends on you, Shyam, for CFA. You must be knowing the structure of CFA, right? You can give level 1 in June and December both, and level 2 onwards, you can give the exam just on June section, right? Level 2 and level 3 are just in June, and level 1 is June and December both. And I'm presuming you're doing you're into your last year right now. So June mein to exams honge. In this June, you might have some exams. So it won't be advisable for you to start studying for CFA for this June itself, right? So just give me a background. When are your final exams getting over? Oh, you're in third year, right? So if you're in third year right now, then your CFA will not allow you to give exam in June. You will be actually eligible to give exam while you are in last year of your college. But sadly, CFA exams are in December and in June, both of which clash with our engineering exams, right? Our engineering exams are during November, December, and then they are in between May, June. So it will be too much an ask for you to even study for engineering and do a CFA during your engineering. Although CFA is just one day, it's a Saturday exam. But let me tell you, it's not a cakewalk. So do you have any idea about CFA, or should I just explain it to you what exactly is CFA and how can you tackle it in best possible way? Do you need me to explain you the CFA part of it? Okay, cool. So let me just give you a background about how I managed to give us this CFA. I did not give CFA in December. I gave CFA in June. So that's 3 years of June, which I invested in giving CFA. And that's how I cleared my CFA level 3 after engineering. But the most optimal way for one to do CFA, which I actually have suggested to many of your fourth year students when they call me, when can I do CFA? So just give your final year exams in June. And that will be next June, right? So June 2020, you give your final year exam. And since you have a leeway of giving CFA level 1 in December as well, you can attempt CFA level 1 in December 2020, right? So in December 2020, you will attempt your CFA level 1. And in about a month, you get your result of CFA level 1. If you clear your CFA level 1, you can immediately enroll for CFA level 2 and give that exam in June 2021. So after your engineering in 1 year, you have completed CFA level 1 and CFA level 2. Now, risk of doing it is you don't get enough time to study for CFA level 2. And by time, I mean you're managing work as well as your CFA, right? So that somehow becomes a little ask. But again, I would advise you to give during that time itself by December and June, because in 1 year, if you actually play your game on fifth gear, in 1 year, you will have CFA level 1 and CFA level 2 as well. So in 1 year, you're probably a level 2 candidate who has good amount of level 2, level 3 candidates who has a lot of respect in the industry as well, right? So I would suggest you to give your CFA post your final year exam. Now, some cautionary statements about it is, one, CFA is a little expensive course that way. So don't mix it up with your engineering. That's my strict advice to you. I had one friend who did that, who cleared it, but I know how difficult it got in the end for him. And he had great project partners. So sir, project mein ek, like not even single slide of PPT or not even single soldering in the project usne kiya tha, right? So all these things need to come to your help if you have to clear the CFA along with your engineering. Now, giving CFA is not just a monetary hustle, but also physically and mentally you will be a little cramped up, because after your engineering, you will be doing your job and you will be just getting accustomed to a new lifestyle, new culture, and you will be probably you'll be really probably be cramped up for so many things. Let's say you're getting a job, like you're in third year, I'm guessing you don't have a placement in hand right now, right? So in probably next year, if you are placed outside of your city and you're managing that as well, you're managing CFA as well, so things are going to get cramped up. But assure you that it'll be worth it, because CFA will give you a great overview of what finance looks like, at least theoretically. In real life, as we know, everything's different. People learn acting as well on books. There are books on how to do acting, but I'm sure Ranbir Kapoor or Ranbir Singh haven't read them, right? So it will give you a good background of exactly what financial world will look like for you, and then you can take a call probably ki aage ye karna hai ki nahi karna, because since you're in third year, I'm sure you must have not heard about what exactly happens in finance. It's just this one company, JP Morgan, who gives you great package, comes to SC and gives it in everybody's head in a SCIT that finance mein career bahut karne se bahut kuch paar ho sakta hai, right? So I am sure even you are biased by that presumption right now, and that must be one of your dream companies, and it should be in its right way, because if you're in third year right now, you have great shot for JP Morgan CRG next year, and you should connect with some seniors who are already working there, like Michelle Whittaker. I don't know if you know about her. She can really help you out with the interview process. कैसे होता है, कैसे हेल्प कर सकते हैं, कैसे इंटरव्यू दे सकते हैं, यू शुड रीच आउट टू दोस गाइस. यू कैन रीच आउट टू देम ऑन लिंक्डइन, व्हाट्सएप मैसेज, मेल, एनीथिंग, बट रीच आउट टू पीपल हु आर ऑलरेडी वर्किंग इन जेपी मॉर्गन सो दैट यू कैन गेट अ ग्रेट आइडिया कि काम कैसे होता है. बट कमिंग बैक टू CFA, इट विल बी रियली क्रैम्प्ड अप, बट आई रियली अर्ज यू टू गिव दैट अप in first year itself, like level 1 in December and level 2 in June, because it will really give you two things. Level, agar acha lagta hai finance, to ek saal mein yaar tum do CFA level 2 ho gaye. Agar acha nahi lag raha hai finance, ye mujhe nahi karna hai, maybe I am placed with, let's say, Deloitte right now and risk consulting acha lag raha hai mujhe, aage nahi jaane ka hai. So you have saved lot of time, you have saved effort for future, and you can explore opportunities in Deloitte. So don't be fixated on the finance hi karna hai. Give level 1 and level 2 in a year. You'll probably understand what exactly is CFA and what exactly will be the how finance will look like. And then take it forward to level 3 data and then. Like for example, I have really great personality. I don't know if you have heard about her, Aditi Fadnes, who is again our alumni, one of my good friends and my batchmate. She gave level 1 and level 2 and then decided ki finance mein career nahi karna hai, and she was working in JP Morgan CRG. Imagine, like, she had so many things working for her, JP Morgan CRG, CFA level 2 bhi ho gaya, and then she decided ki career nahi karna hai finance. So level 2 dene ke baad utna clear ho jata hai ki career karna hai finance mein ya nahi karna hai, because you get to know the entire ball game ki finance kya hai. There are about 10 subjects in CFA. And imagine giving 10 subjects in one day. Engineering mein aadat pad gaya 6 din ki chutti ke baad ek subject dene ka. Here you have to give 10 subjects in one day itself for 6 hours. So it's altogether a different ball game. I cannot differentiate which one's easy, which one's difficult. Both of them are actually similar with respect to the grind you have to do. But in CFA, if you are a guy who depends on your logic more than your memory, then CFA is something which you will really enjoy, because memorize karne ke liye itna kuch hai nahi, or like if you have done good amount of memorization of formulas, so logic tumko sambhalne ka ki kaise clear karte, right? So right now I you're in third year, so I am again presuming itna zyada kuch CFA ke bare mein bhi nahi pada hai. It's just a hot cake right now in the industry. Every engineer is doing a CFA to get a career into finance. So even I'm sure you must be very intrigued by that fact that CFA hota kya hai. So let me just ask you a few questions on CFA. Like if you have any particular question regarding CFA, ki padhte kaise hai, ya fir what classes to join and what exactly do you require to give CFA? I'm happy to answer those questions right now. Cool. So let me know if you have taken any classes in engineering. Have you taken any classes in engineering as well? Okay, in SEM 1 only. Fine. Everybody does that. Ram Kumar ke paas gaye hoge mechanics ke liye. Anyway. Yeah. So, yeah. CFA mein, if this was philosophical lecture, I would have told you classes mat lena. I am highly against CFA level 1 classes, but again I understand the kind of challenge. Like I myself, I had taken classes for level 1, right? Because as an engineer, we don't know the even basic terms of CFA. Ki kya hai? So I'm just typing out one of the classes which I went to, which is really good, Lokik Shah. Yeah, and you will find many online classes as well. So, but here, this guy, Lokik Shah, he takes classes in Borivali and Dadar. So he takes classes on weekends as well for working professionals. Weekend pe subah 5 se 10 mein classes khatam ho jate hai. And I would advise if you think that you won't have much time to, one second, I'll just type it out in a different window. Sorry, I type it on personal window of my view. So this is Lokik Shah, sir, who takes classes in Borivali and Dadar. And this guy, So like a private tutor, like अपना राम कुमार कैसे थे वहाँ पे, like he's a private tutor as such, जिनका one man show है, पूरा का पूरा 10 subject वो खुद पढ़ाते हैं, and he has weekend batches, weekday batches, you can swap whenever you want, so that way he is that one person जिसके पास you can go for classes and for help, and he has many batches as well, not only one batch. Let me just put down his number as well, so that in future, let's just type down this number. Yeah, so that is his number. Again, giving you a background of CFA classes. CFA classes will be a little different than what our 12th standard or engineering classes were. There will be practice in any class. So, theory padha ke chale jayenge, because he also understands that you have paid 1 lakh rupees, you are a 21-year-old guy who understands ki paisa important hai, effort important hai, time limited hai. So he will expect you to do major work, and his work will be only 10-15% to 20% max of letting you clear CFA. Major grind to aapko hi karna hai, laukik sha nahi karna hai. But what he makes sure is you understand which subject to study when, what exactly is expected out of each subject, kaunsa subject kitna padhna hai, and some basic concepts of kaise cheeze, because there are going to be some subjects which even if you read 5 times you won't understand them, because you are not a commerce guy, you lack that basic instinct of commerce, that basic instinct of how supply and demand work. So he is a good guy that way to understand ki kaam kaise hota hai ye sari cheeze. But again, to clear a CFA, you require 80% of your effort, and this guy will be less than 20%. He'll give you good notes as well. You have to buy Schweizer notes, which he'll tell you. So basically, he'll tell you exactly what you need to clear for CFA, and then the effort is, the onus is on you, right? There are a couple of online classes as well, but since you'll be a working professional, I refrain you from joining online classes, because ऑनलाइन करोगे तो तुम पे है, अगर तुम पे छोड़ दिया वो सब तुम कभी नहीं करोगे, बिकॉज ट्रस्ट मी राइट नाउ यू वोंट रियलाइज दैट, बट मंडे टू फ्राइडे 10 घंटे तक काम करने के बाद अगर सैटरडे किसी ने मुझे बोला कि 10 बजे सुबह ऑनलाइन क्लासेस कर, तो मैं नहीं खोलूंगा. आई विल फाइंड रीजन टू नॉट वेक अप एंड हैव दैट ग्राइंड. सो आई रियली अर्ज यू टू गो टू दिस मैन, ही विल बी वेरी फ्लेक्सिबल, इज अ चिल गाय, ही वोंट इवन गेट बॉदर्ड अगर क्लास में लेट आए, क्लास में बात किया. Like I said, he expects you to be mature. He don't expect you to be spoon fed, right? So that is what you will require. You are in that college zone, college mode, self standard. You will learn everything and you will do the revision. But here it won't be like that. So just getting expectation settings in place. And any other specific doubt about CFA, or there are certain doubts about FRM as well? You must have heard about FRM as a course as well, right? So you have any CFA specific doubts as to kya exactly CFA hai, or like any CFA doubt or FRM doubt? Internship. So see, right now you're in third year, so yeah, you have good amount of time for internship. That intern.com, which actually gives a lot of internships, you can find out what exactly do finance internships have you for offer. But what kind of time frames are you looking for? 1 month, 2 months, 3 months? Because when is college vacation? Can you let me know that? What exactly is the vacation period? So that's about 1.5 months. Okay. To be very frank here, I actually don't know much about internships as of now. If I come across any internship, I'll probably let you know. I'll let Ayur know that let Sham know about certain internships. But I'm sure if you Google it for 15-20 minutes, you can find out what kind of internships are there available. About finance field, yaar, see, to give you a very frank opinion about this, I'm into investment banking and I'm looking to switch into VC or PE very soon. Okay. So all these fields are very, very, like a person doing equity research can shift to investment banking and then can shift to VC very easily. So these are very closely knit domains in finance if you're working in core finance, right? So since they are very, very closely knit domains, you have certain amount of X, Y, Z skill set, and then you can go into any domain of your choice. And doing an internship of 1.5 months won't actually give you a background to your field mein hota kya, because you won't be a part of any deal. Any deal which happens will take at least 3 to 4 months from conceptualization period to an execution. So internship won't give you an idea about which field to decide in finance, to be very frank, in any case. What you can do is you can get to know culture kaisa hota hai, you can get to know exactly what people are what kind of people you'll be working with, because right now peers won't really matter to you because everyone is your friend. But if somebody tells me that you have only juniors in your firm, I will never join that firm, because for me peers are much more important than the kind of technical work happens there, because you learn from your peers more than any, right? So इंटर्नशिप से पता तो नहीं चलेगा कौन सा फील लेना, इंटर्नशिप से कुछ कल्चर पता कर सकते हो, या मेरे पीयर्स कौन से हो सकते हैं वो पता कर सकते हो कि दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ पीयर सेट विच आई हैव इन द फर्म एंड वेदर यू वांट इट और नो. लाइक इफ यू आर इन फ्रॉम एसटीआईटी एंड यू हैव ग्राइंड योरसेल्फ इन 12th एंड एसटीएम पहुंचे, तो अगर पीयर सेट तुम्हारा कोई टीयर 3 और 4 इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज है जिसका नाम किसी ने भी नहीं सुना है, so you will not find it good to join that firm, right? So that is the only thing internship can offer you. So I don't think so internship has really much value to add apart from knowing your peers. Again, just to give you an update, we have about 7 minutes left to close this session. So if you have any queries, just shoot them and I'll just keep answering them right now. You have any queries, Shyam? Anything like CFA, FI, and job, internship, whatever comes to your mind as of now. Let's utilize these 6 minutes very well. Cool. So I see you don't have any queries as such. So it'll be okay for you if I just summarize what I've told you, because I'm sure I've given you too much information. So it'll be great if I can summarize in next couple of minutes. Is that okay? Yeah. So whatever I've noted down, I'll just tell you about it. And since you are a third year student, I'll start with academics as well. But for CFA, I would really urge you to start your preparation in December, right after your graduation. December mein level 1 de do, and June mein level 2 de do. And accordingly, you have basically have cleared your level 1 and 2 in 1 year. That's the best case scenario, right, I'm talking about, right? Now, how can you manage that is up to your job, up to too many macro things involved. Tum ghar pe reh rahe ho, ghar se bahar reh rahe ho. What kind of job boss you have, then to chutti dega ya nahi dega, all these things come into picture during that time, right? But the best case scenario is to give CFA level 1 in December and then immediately give level 2. Regarding FRM, which we have not discussed, I'll just summarize. FRM is a subset of CFA. So if you're giving CFA, don't even think of giving FRM. FRM will be useless for you. You'll just pay a lot of money and basically CFA mein sab cover ho jata hai. So don't even try for FRM unless and until you are looking for a career into risk advisory or anything related to risk. So if you want to write it down. FRM is useful only when you're doing a job which involves risk advisory or anything related to risk of a financial firm. Every financial firm has its own risk department. Agar FRM dene ka soch rahe ho, then you have to be associated with risk department, which we have not covered because it's a very small department to look at. It's not your first choice anyway in any firm. But if you're looking for risk, then FRM is a must. If you're not looking for risk, you can safely skip it and save that money and probably buy some beers of that money. Just to give you a summarization of the kind of domains we have investment banking, equity research, corporate banking. We have VCP funds as of now, and VCP funds are the most exciting and most lucrative with respect to salary. Give you a number, Sequoia Capital mein analyst ka salary 25 lakh hota, right? 25 lakh, and that's not a made up number. I have a friend in Sequoia Capital, but it's very difficult to get into them. But if you are in third year right now, you can write a few papers, you can probably talk to those people ki main kya kar sakta ho, I'm in third year, like find out people on LinkedIn and talk to them ki main kya kar sakta ho, like mereko Sequoia mein jana hai ya mujhe aise koi funds mein jana hai. Just type out kitne funds available hai India mein, and pata chal jayega ki wo fund mein kaun kaam kar raha hai. Go to their team. If you go to their team, go to their LinkedIn and just message there. Start spamming those people, and out of 10, at least 2 will reply. That should be your success rate. 10 mein se 2 jan ne agar reply kar diya to main successful, right? Start spamming them and understand from their point of view, why would they hire a fresher from engineer? But there you have a great salary, great understanding of the business, and if in future you want to have your own startup, that is the best way. Generally log apna startup kholte hai, startup bechte hai aur VC bante hai. But again, right now there's a trend that log VC join karte hai, understand the ecosystem and then startup kholte hai. With respect to investment banking like you have quite a few US based firms like JP, Citi, Deutsche Bank, Barclays, who have lots of work outside of India, and they outsource their work in India, right? So you will be their service provider basically. And those kind of jobs are good starting point after engineering, but those shouldn't be your goal after 2 years of engineering. So agar CFA agar clear hota hai successfully, so just fuck off from there and don't even try to be in those kind of firms. Your learning will be really, really, really limited, right? Apart from that, there are very, India follows boutique culture, and boutique mein bahut zyada opportunity and scope rehta hai, but you'll have to do some certain, you have to show them inclination by doing some Coursera courses or anything which is going to be inclined towards finance, certain technical skills if you can develop through courses, and just let them know that you are interested, and I'm sure they will get back to you. Just I've typed a few names of those boutiques, but that is not even 1% of it. If you type out top 10 boutique firms in India, top 50 boutique firms in India, I am sure after 10 minutes of Google research, you'll understand concept. And then there are these banks, Indian banks, ICICI, Citibank, everybody has their own investment banking arm. Kotak has a very, very active investment banking arm. SBI has active investment banking arm. You can approach them right now. You can approach them for internships as well. But I want to do an internship. Do an unpaid internship out there for 1.5 months. You might understand, or they might understand what you actually require, right? I think I've given too much information right now, and our session of 1 hour is also getting over right now. So it was good to know you, yeah. It was good to give someone knowledge, and I think I've given you a good amount of, I think, information to start off with. And since you're in third year, I think it will be great for you to build upon this. Like, consider this information as just a building block. Like, if you're a child, you just started to stand up, not even walk, right? So I think it was really helpful for you. Let me know your views on that. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining as well. Thank you, Ayu, for giving us such a great platform. It was great to collaborate with one of my college junior and give him certain knowledge about what exactly finance is, right? And Sam, if you have any queries, I'm sure you can reach out to Ayur about them, and I will convey it to you. Cool? Yeah, bye-bye, Sam. Thank